So let me introduce our guest today, Amandeep. Amandeep is a world-renowned international speaker, trainer, and empowerment coach. Over the last 14 years, he has experimentally developed simple yet powerful techniques that have impacted over a million lives. Amandeep is the living embodiment of empowerment who transforms lives by changing mindsets. He has worked with the best personal trainers like Tony Robbins, T. Harv Eker, Robin Kiyosaki, Les Brown, and many others. Over the last 10 years, he's been the lead trainer for Tony Robbins with previews across UK, Europe, Australia, and the Middle East. He has authored multiple books and is working on the next one. He has conducted impactful trainings for top brands across the globe. So let's know more about him from the man himself.
Thank you, Premraji. Thank you, Deepak. And thank you, Team Bloom, for having me here. Look, my life is Hollywood movies. We're coming back very quickly. You know, I started from a very humble background. I'm a taxi driver's son. You know, my parents are illiterate. They can't read and write. And I'm a very deadly combination, which I understand now. But I thought it's a challenge, you know, during my early stages. My dad is Punjabi, very fair in complexion. My mom is Bengali, Samla Rang hai unka. So, you know, I'm a fusion of North and East. And I grew up with the understanding that, you know, there is something wrong with me as a human being, that I'm not pure enough as a human being. I didn't look like my father. I didn't look like a Singh, a Sardar. And I had a lot of issues, you know. I was overweight. I was bullied and abused. And living in a one-room house in Calcutta, we had a lot of financial challenges. So there was a time in my life I wanted to give up on my life and commit suicide. I was suicidal at the age of 16 when we had to relocate from Calcutta to a remote village in Punjab. There's a district called Sangrur. A lot of people don't know, but it's like 50 miles, you know, away from Ludhiana. And somehow, you know, I got introduced to a personal development, something like what is happening right now, like Bloom, somebody's watching and you never know whose life might get impacted. So I don't know how MBA, you know, got my name and address. What was the marketing campaign? But God bless that marketing campaign. I got a letter, you know, in my house, which I read. And for the first time, my need of significance got fulfilled. Very quickly, you know, we have six human needs. One of the needs we need to have is to know that we are special, you know, something good is about us. So I went to Amber's meeting and I saw Dr. Brad presenting. And that's the first, you know, desire inside me came up that I would like to do what this man is doing from the stage. You know, he is mesmerizing, captivating the audience and motivating them. I started reading books and I got to, you know about Tony's work when I came, you know, I mean, I was in India when I read his book in 2003, but in 2006, when I came to the UK under a scholarship, which was given to me by my cousin, God bless him. He just lives, you know, a few miles away from here. And my journey for UK started. I would have never made it to the UK because I didn't have the money to pay for the college fees. And when I was looking for a part-time job, I landed up on a free book campaign of Tony and attended his UPW, Unleash the Power Within, in 2007. And on the third day at UPW, I had a major, major breakthrough. And that's where I made a decision. You know what? I would like to do something on the lines of what this man is doing, is to help, you know, and impact people to have a better version of themselves.
Why is it that in your experience, you feel most people struggle with relationship issues leading to conflicts?
You know, there are a few powerful things I've learned from a lady called Veronica Tan. She is the owner of Success Resources. And if some of you don't know this, I used to work in the office for Success Resources. I was their client to begin with almost 11 years back. Then I was a volunteer for almost 2 years. And then I worked in the office for 5 years. And there is something amazing I learned about Veronica, about, you know, masculine and feminine energy. And also something, you know, is related to Date with Destiny, Tony's program. Veronica said, I always let, you know, Richard, which is Veronica's husband, win so that I can win bigger. She says, you know what? Richard is the head of the company and I am the neck. So he turns where I turn, where I came to turn. And very quickly, you know, understand the men's psychology is that if you're not going out and hunting, you know, because our brain is pretty thousands of years old. So if you're not making a living, we don't feel like men, you know. So we're not normally the people who share our emotions. And if you ever do, ladies in the house, just listen, okay? Because women, men find it very difficult to open up. And all this bullshit, you know, which has been sold to us, we cry, you know, in silence and in loneliness. And ladies, but for the men in the house, understand when ladies are speaking, and I obviously make efforts to do that. Sometimes I'm not able to do it. they relay information. They just want somebody to hear them out. They don't want a solution, but we are fixers, you know. We want to fix things. So very quickly, it's about understanding. It's about finding, you know, that mutual ground to carry on the journey, saying, you know what, no matter what, we promise to go further, you know, on this. We may have our differences, but we still continue to, you know, go on this journey.
According to a survey, about 85% of employees are not fully engaged at work. Your thoughts on this sad fact? Why? What do you feel can be done to make employees more engaged at work?
I can talk from my experience. I think I've been blessed in most occasions to work in places where, you know, I was super excited to be there. Like, you know, my call center experience, you know, most maybe employees feel, you know, left out or not part of the bigger picture. Like, you know, you can speak to my team, you know, my team is here, Hina, Kavita and Akansha, Vikas, they work with me. I mean, most of the time, like sometimes, you know, maybe I fail in that. Most of the time, you know, I bring them along on that journey of a bigger picture with me. And this is my understanding that if most employees, first of all, as an employee point of view, you must be working in a space where it's learning, where it's challenging you, and it is at least have some part of interest in that work you do. If it is completely opposite to, you know, what you plan to do in your life or you have some interest about, I think you will struggle even with somebody including you in the bigger picture. And, you know, I take this a lot of pride in saying that there have been many occasions people who have joined my company and within a month they have left. And it's a blessing because they said, you know what? Oh, sir, I'm so sorry, you know, but I cannot work with you because what I got from you in this few days, I know now what I want to do. You know, some of them are creating their music. Some of them are running their blog posts. Some of them are doing other stuff, you know, journalism.
What would you say are the keys to goal setting for individuals and corporates?
Something I'm still working on. I still go back, you know, to what Veronica would say, Veronica Tan from Success Resources. And she would say, Amandeep, whether you like it or not, but numbers, they speak. And that's the truth of life. If you do your numbers on a regular basis from a corporate point of view, it will give you that drive. And some may call it motivation. Somebody like me calls it inspiration. But, you know, it kind of, you know, puts you in more action than normally you would do. Like, let's say, you know, if you were catching a flight and if you know the time and you know there's only half an hour left for you to be there to board the plane, your speed, you know, goes up. Even if you're a guy with a bit of a, let's say, weight, but you still run in whatever capacity you can so that you don't miss the flight. So the corporate space, again, you've got to have a number in the beginning of your year. It could be financial year. It could be the normal year. But you know what? This is what we're aiming for this year from, let's say, I have got like two chapters I run, Indian chapter and the UK chapter. So, yeah. Separate two chapters. This is in pounds. This is in, you know, rupees or dollars. So you got to have a target. You know, you can call it a map. You can call it a plan. Whatever you want to call it, doesn't matter. You know, I mean, sometimes we get caught up in the words because some words have certain, you know, like association because of the past. But understand, if you are not aiming for something, you know, you will not reach anywhere. You don't catch a train or a plane. We don't know where it's going. So please do have a goal setting.
I have been on both the sides, when you are doing a program and from the other side, when you are planning and executing the program. I've seen you cry on the stage when you are sharing your personal story. There are times one feels that, you know, this guy is crying just to gather attention or, you know, just to gather sympathy. And there are times when it just feels ki, yaar, iske dil se nikal raha hai. I just want you to tell us how that happens. How do you get into a state where those tears start flowing when you are telling your story? You know, you could easily stand up and not cry and decide, no, I want to tell my story.
Aapka sach hai na, wo aapko wahan le jata hai. Kabhi-kabhi bahut mushkil hai samajhna ki agar aap ek kamre ke makan mein ek taxi driver ke bete ban ke rehte ho aur jab chappal aapke naseeb mein nahi hoti us tarah se aur padosi ka aap grocery utha ke laate ho ration ताकि आपको एक कोको कोला की बॉटल मिल सके वहां से आप जहां पहुंच जाते हो यू नो इट्स लाइक अ इमोशन यू फील यू नो इट्स लाइक अ गश ऑफ जॉय ऑफ यू नो टीयर्स ऑफ जॉय मे बी और समटाइम्स यू रीविजिट दोज इमोशंस एंड यू कैन नॉट हेल्प इट बट लुक बैक एंड से यू नो व्हाट वाओ यू नो हाउ मच लाइफ यू नो हैज चेंज एंड शिफ्टेड नाउ फ्रॉम अ टेक्निक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू यू नो एज अ टीचर ट्रेनर See, you have to understand when you share your journey, your story, you know, it has to be relatable. It has to be believable. It has to, you know, build your credibility and authority in front of the listeners that they would like to go on a journey with you. Yeah. Very quickly, I will be sharing this, you know, in the masterclass today about storytelling. You know, people have left and right brain. And, you know, in your room, you can have left brain dominant people. You can have right brain dominant people, which doesn't mean they don't have the other side. They do.
Yeah.
But, you know, few people or maybe a lot of people who are logical brain oriented, they need facts and figures, your experiences, yeah. your achievements, your third party borrowed credentials, all that stuff. But then there are people in the room, you know, it doesn't bother to, you know, doesn't matter to them whether you're a graduate, whether you're a Tony Robbins trainer, whether you are a master's, doesn't matter. They want to know, my friend, you know, did you feel the pain which I'm feeling? And have you been able to overcome that? And if you have, then I would like to go on a journey with you. They're right brain people. They're color people. They're creative people. They're people like who created Walt Disney, you know, Disneyland.
Yeah.
So from a technique point of view, if you're okay to show some part of your vulnerability, they relate to you at a deeper level, going, you know, अरे ये तो अपने जैसा ही है यार, अरे अच्छा इसको भी बड़ी तकलीफ हुई, अच्छा ये तो इतना strong नहीं था, लग रहा था शुरू में भाई साहब, हमें लगा ये तो ऐसे ही पैदा हुआ है, अच्छा तो तुमको भी बात करनी नहीं आती थी सामने लोगों के, अच्छा तुम भी घबराते थे, अच्छा तुम्हारी भी टांग कांपते थे, अच्छा तुम अच्छा अरे अच्छा ओके अरे भैया चलो अब चलते हैं तुम्हारे साथ हम. सो ये तो आपका सच है, यू नो, आप जब सच के बारे में बात करते हो. और मैं डॉक्टर जॉन डी मार्टिनी को कोट करना चाहता हूँ. यू नो, आई हैड द ब्लेसिंग टू शेयर द स्टेज विद हिम इन सक्सेस अट्रैक्शन समिट. And I love what he says, you know, that if your passion doesn't bring tears from your eyes, because tear is a form of emotion, you know, is an overwhelming emotion, then maybe, you know, there's a possibility you haven't yet found your passion. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, your passion must bring tears. And you say, I'm on stage, I'm crying now, 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 I'm crying now